later fled to our side and became Democrats. When's the last time you've heard that happening in the last 25 years? But two of them came over, which leads me briefly to my favorite ever story about a Democrat, a Republican that flipped to the Democratic side. I just got to tell you, and it was the great big fat guy from Oklahoma, Dale Patrick, and then your guy from Oklahoma City, George Osborne. Let me tell you this story about some Barney Cole. You were the moderator, done or close?
I don't think I was.
Okay. You were still there.
I was there.
With the speaker maybe at that time?
No. Oh. I was just a member.
Okay. Here's what happened. We had convinced big old fat devil Patrick, who was a bondsman. I mean big and fat. He weighed nearly 400 pounds. I'm not making that up. To flip to the Democratic side. They hated his guts, and they should have. Well, Dale Patrick had access to Cuban cigars. And it was back when Glover owned the legislature. Remember, I told you he was going to whip my ass if I ever brought up banning smoking on the House floor and all that. And so I never brought it up again. But anyway. Dale Patrick would walk around with this box of beautiful Cuban cigars. Mr. Speaker, did you ever get a Cuban cigar? Okay, I'm not going to ask the judge. Anyway, Dale was doing his deal. George Osborne was an insurance man from Northwest Oklahoma City. He wasn't as big as Dale Patrick, but he was pretty big. Would you say 250, 280?
Bigger than
that? Over 300 pounds. So we got 400 pounds versus 300 pounds, and they hate each other. Osborne is not a smoker, he's an insurance guy. Patrick is crazy, a bondsman, smokes like crazy. He's walking around on the House floor like he always did with a box of Cuban cigars. And almost everybody's taking one, lighting up, and having a big time. And Dale decides to go over to the Republican aisle, where, over here, where three is. Next, that eye. And he's moseying down there with his cigar all lit up and everything. Hammering out, everybody's kind of taking him and he's having a big time. And he gets to Representing Osborne, who hates his guts and is not a smoker. And Dale says, Representative Osborne, would you care for a cigar? And I don't know what Osborne said, but it wasn't very pleasant. And so Dale, being the kind of guy he was, he looks at him and flips his cigar, about that much ash, A-S-H, onto Osborne's tie. They both jump up, and I'm not making this up, and they hear they come at each other, boom, big swings, and they both grab each other's ties, but they were clip-on ties. Glover's got Osborne by a neck hole, got him near death, and little Kevin Cox, little black guy from Oklahoma City, is like a bulldog. He's got Osborne's leg, and he's bulldogging him by Kevin.